must each do it for yourself. And it is a tricky one. Perhaps one of the trickiest in many ways that I can devise. You must understand, however, the basis for the experiment that I am proposing. You must realize, first of all, that your private reality is one of numberless probable realities. You are experiencing one of many probable realities. Now, because of your neurological structure, you can only physically perceive, in your terms, so many events at once. Therefore, from an unlimited number of probable events, you choose those which you will perceive through your physical system in terms of time and biological reality. It seems to you as I speak, however, that the reality that you know is rock-bed reality and that all other realities are probable. Instead, you are perceiving and experiencing one of many probable realities for yourself. You must understand that or the experiment will not work. If you insist on thinking of your present reality as rock-bed reality and everything else is probable, then the experiment will not work. So first of all, you must realize that you are experiencing one probable reality of many. Now, take each of you an area of your life with which you are not pleased in your terms. Think of it. Now, do not think of it in terms of rock-bed reality, but as one of many probable realities that you have brought into your experience because of your belief. Now hold in your mind the idea that there are other probable realities in that one area that you can just as easily pull into your physical experience and experience this biologically, practically, and intimately in your daily life. Then, for perhaps 5 minutes a day and no more, imagine yourself, through your beliefs, pulling that portion of probable reality into your own. For that amount of time, you must, however, change your belief in that area. You must realize that your belief pulls the reality to you. And therefore, only now, for 5 minutes, change the belief. And if you do this faithfully, you will find your reality in that area changing.